Okay, so what does a graph look like? Ah, wait, no. I've been conditioned to think of a graph as a chart that shows trends, like a line graph or a graph of a function. But that's not what we're talking about here. Let me try again. Our definition of a graph looks more like this. The purpose of a graph is to show how different things are connected to one another. It's also sometimes called a network. A graph is similar to a tree in many ways. For starters, these are called nodes or vertices, and these lines over here are called edges. In fact, a tree is just a more specific type of graph. It's just like a binary tree is a type of tree, and a BST is a type of binary tree. Here's an example of a valid graph, where you can really start anywhere and you'll follow some path back to the start. Since cycles like this one are possible, graphs don't really have a root node like trees do. Graphs are really vaguely defined, but we should keep it that way. As you've probably come to expect, we need to keep it vague so our definition will encompass all of the different use cases for our graph. For example, I would love to say that nodes are the parts of graphs that store data, and edges are just the connections between them. But edges can actually store data too. Since graphs can seem really abstract at the start, let's make them more concrete with some examples. Let's imagine this graph as a social network. This node can be me. I can draw the rest of the graph like this. Here, it's clear that nodes are people, but the edges between the nodes could be describing any connection between us. Maybe it's people who've met each other. Here, two nodes that are connected by an edge, sometimes called adjacent, have met each other in person. This could be a graph of people who've lived in the same city at the same time, or people who've worked on a project together. The nodes could contain any amount of data, like each person's full name, where they live now, their birthday, etc. As I said before, edges could contain data too. Edges often contain data about the strength of a connection. For example, these edges could show how many times in the past week we talked to each other. Okay, let's think about a new example. Let's say this graph is my travel plans for a big trip. I'm going to fly from San Francisco to Tokyo, then Kuala Lumpur, then Delhi, then back to KL, Tokyo, and SF. The edges could contain no information, or they could contain how long the flights are. The information I decide to store will depend on what I'm using this graph for.